I'm Shahid Mogh from debugagent.com. Today we'll talk about one of the biggest security problems in many programming languages, serialization. It lets you read a bunch of bytes and convert them to an object. Seems harmless enough, right? Unfortunately, there are many nuanced problems with serialization. The gift that keeps giving, as Brian Vermeer says in his talk, Serialization Hacks. It's a great talk that you should check out in the link here. He goes into a lot of details on why serialization is risky and problematic. That's very valuable, but it's also very scary. Serialization chains that you can generate with a simple tool to create an exploit. Scary stuff. I'm more interested in the solution. How do we make sure that the next 0 day doesn't impact us? How do we harden our server code against serialization attacks? Do we even need serialization in this day and age? Well, not always. Ideally, if you can remove serialization entirely from your code and can avoid third-party code that uses serialization, you can just block it. This will mean that even if a 0 day comes up, the serialization portion will fail. You might have a bug, but it won't be exploitable. But sometimes we need a bit of serialization. In that case, we can include only the well-known classes that we need and block everything else out. The solution came in Java 9 in the form of serialization filtering as part of JEC 290. There are critical patch updates for older JDKs, such as JDK 8 U121. So if you must stay in an older version, you might have a path to get this. You might be able to do this with no code changes, although you might want to add some. There are two approaches of allowing only specific serialization objects, or blocking specific objects. The latter lets us block well-known vulnerabilities, and that might be enough. But we have no guarantee. A whitelist is a more secure option, yet it might break your code if you missed a class that's required on an edge case. We can set the filter on the JDK itself by editing the java.securityproperties file. That might make sense if you package a JDK with your application. Personally, I prefer using the command line argument. This command will block all serialization. Notice I need to use the quotes to prevent bash from expanding the star sign. The exclamation point means we wish to block, and the star means we block everything. This is a blacklist. We're blocking a specific package. We can also narrow it down to a specific class. But as I said before, this isn't ideal. Here we have a whitelist where the classes under my package are allowed. They can be serialized. Everything else is blocked. This is pretty close to the ideal situation. We can add additional classes and packages as necessary by adding them and separating them with a semicolon. How do you know which classes are serialized in the code? How do you get an alert if your code blocked a serialization attempt? This might be something you would want to track, since it might be the system breaking or it might be an attempted hack. Both are valid reasons for an alert. You can't do that declaratively, but you can write code that can use sophisticated logic to determine whether serialization should succeed. This is a sample from the Oracle documentation of a simple serialization filter. Notice it can reject the serialization or leave it undecided. This is a part of a filter chain where each stage in the validation process can reject the serialization or pass it on to the next stage, we can bind the filter globally as we do here, or do it on a per stream basis. The API is remarkably flexible and provides a lot of information about the process. There's a lot I didn't discuss here, such as logging, JMX support, and so much more. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions, and check out the link to Brian's talk in the end credits.